Well, here I am. We're on the 10th tee, and I'm with Jason Glanz. He's Golf Operations Manager and Head Professional here at Eagle Ridge. And it's great to be here with you, Jace.
No worries, mate.
And great hole, this 10th hole of today, especially. It's into the breeze. It's a real testing par 4. It's about 450 yards all the way into the breeze. So you're going to lead us off?
Do a good job to get there.
Okay. You're my leader. Have a lot of fun playing balls on the 9 here at Eagle Ridge. Well, you got good contacts. Will it get to that bunker? Just short. I mean, you must know the course.
Yes.
Okay.
Just short.
Things for sure. If you can't get there, then I'm not going to get there either. But this hole really is there's a bit of fairway there, and the wind's coming a little bit from left to right and into us. A bit lower wind under the wind.
Yeah,
I might be in that fairway bunker. That'll be a good test. So thanks, Jake. Let's check out what you're doing there, buddy. And you know that Jake's got no excuses because he's been practicing. He's been playing golf for about 5 months, and he's loving it. He's in the middle of a fairway, but it's the 18th fairway. Well, Jake, I'm in the fairway bunker, but it's a pretty shallow one, a long one. And 240 yards still to go, so.
Right into that wind. It's
a strong wind.
Links golf at its best.
Yeah, well, my lie is good, so I'm just going to be playing my rescue out of here. Just put it up there in front of the green.
Chuck it, bud.
Happy out there, so
play.
I got a pitch and a putt.
Yeah. Okay,
Jason, you're taking an iron.
Yes, yeah, so I've got an iron, so I'm just going to try and just put it out towards the front edge of the green. And
we can't quite reach it from here.
Try and make a pitch and a putt.
Yeah, good on you, bud. Well, you're out and about, mate, so you're in the fairway. Definitely can get the green near the hole from there. Okay, Jake, well look, you've hit the middle of the fairway, but it's the other fairway, so you've got to come back into play.
Yes.
Now, you've got the rescue out there.
I do.
Mate, I would not, this is a bit of advice, playing advice for you.
Yep.
You can't get the green. It's 230, 240 yards to the green.
Yep.
I would be taking a 7-iron out from here, 8-iron.
Okay.
Just get out over the trees, back in the fairway, and then you probably got an 8-iron back to the green. So
all right.
Knock it on for 3 and make a 5. That's what you call playing percentages. Don't go for broke at this stage. Fantastic. Played like a pro. You're right there, buddy.
Yeah, should be. Hopefully in the fairway.
Enjoy the hit. Jason, you're here, you've got about 125 yards uphill into the wind and over a bunker. So tell us your plan of attack here, your strategy.
Okay, so with the strong wind into us and uphill a bit, I'm just going to aim it out a bit to the right and let the wind bring it across into the middle of the green. Then if we get too much of the wind, it's still pretty safe.
Fair enough. So most important, you get plenty of club, isn't it?
Got plenty of club, play a low shot into the wind.
Okie dokie.
Tell you what, that's a good one.
You hit that, sweet. You've been practicing. Wow.
Great shot.
So it must have been good strategy.
Good hit, yep. Low shot.
Thank you. Okay, Jake, well, how far have you got in here after that beautiful 8-iron?
100 yards. So that would normally be, without this wind, up to 52 for me.
Because you're pretty powerful.
Yeah. So I've got the pitching wedge out.
Okay.
My strategy is to get it on the green.
Okay, mate. I know I wouldn't. 100 yards. You're a gorilla. Show me how. Wow, you've hit it great. Very high.
It's short.
I think, yeah. Not. Yeah, no, it's pin high. You've got it up there. I tell you, you did hit it pretty powerfully. But it's on the green. That's fantastic. Okay.
A chance it's a par, doesn't it?
Yeah, one putt par, you're in business.
Okay, Pete, what have you got here?
Well, I got about 60 yards uphill into the wind,
yep.
Right to left. I'm just going to take a 52. I'm just going to play a nice little punch shot in here. Rather than hit it hard, when you're into the wind, it take more club and hit it easy, and that doesn't get up in the air so much then.
Yeah.
It'll stop pretty quickly into that wind. I see someone's really close to the pin up there. I think that might be Jason.
Jason.
Yeah. Okay, so it's definitely going to bank off to the right to left. There's a bit of slope in the green, so I'm aiming about 10 feet to the right of the pin. Maybe a little bit more because the ball's above my feet. Be out on the right edge of that bunker at the back of the green is my aiming point. I didn't come back, but safely on the green.
Well, Jake, you could have played an extra club. You're a bit short. It was nicely on line, but the 9-iron would have been better.
Yeah, it would have been.
But I tell you what, Jason is really close to the flag. It was a great shot, Jace. I'm a little bit out to the right, so how would you like the pin down there?
Take it out.
Pin out, ball in. Into the wind. Okay, you gonna mark your shot or do you want to finish it out?
I'll mark it. Okay, Pete, so that looks like a foreign putter in your hand there.
Yeah, I'm just testing yours out today. I thought I might try it out. You were putting so well the other day, I thought I might try your putter.
Yeah, you didn't leave it in the car boot, did you?
I did that as well.
Now, how does that affect your mental? You're a very good putter, Pete. How does
putting with a different putter?
Yeah.
Well, I've tested your putter out before, and this is a really nice putter, so we're not going to go back. We'll play these few holes with your putter, okay?
Perfect.
This is a playing lesson.
Left with a decent putt here. Yeah. 25 footer. Not an easy putt with that wind coming right across him. Tell you what.
Hello.
Tell you what.
Hello.
Not a bad part of this one.
I'll sell it to you, Pete.
I might buy it. Okay, so I'm going to come in behind and see what sort of a line you've got on this. Right, putt.
Good putt, very nice. Good five.
So it's all those lessons, you see. I like that that focus you've got now. You really got a good routine, and enjoy the putt. Okay, so you got to make it three in a row, Jason.
Fingers crossed.
Oh.
Great.
This one. Okie dokie. Well, next hole. Very well done, guys, and great golf hole. It's a great test of golf, number 10. It's the number one hole on the course, isn't it?
I think toughest? It's the second rated.
Second rated. Well, today it's number one.
Number one into the wind today.
Yeah. Right into it. What's probably 20,
25? 450 yards from where we're playing off that tee.
Okay. This is a great looking hole, the 11th.
The 11th, yeah. We've got about, it's 140 yards, 141 yards from here to the pin. We're a little bit protected from the wind in this little place here, but once it gets out there, I think it's going to travel down. What do you reckon, Jace?
At least the club shorter because of the wind.
Yeah. And you're playing an 8, is it?
I'm going to play an 8, yes. Just going to knock it down a little bit.
Isn't it beautiful looking back there? Red Hill and the wineries up there.
Yeah, it's lovely.
It's a nice part of the world.
It is.
The Mornington Peninsula.
That's where we go.
Okay. Shot like that last one will be really good.
It would. Got to get the putt though, don't you?
Well, this one. That's nice and straight.
You've got it a bit. A bit short too.
You took a little bit off that. You could have hit a bit more, couldn't you?
Could have hit it a bit harder.
Yeah. Well, you know, I'm going to take a little bit out of your book. I'm going to play my 7-iron. I'm not quite as young as you. Okay, and definitely the wind's coming from the right, so I'm going to put it a little bit out to the right side of the pin.
A little bit left of the flag. Well, it's on the green. Could be better, but we're putting for it.
Especially putting with Jake's putter.
Yes.
So, Jake, what club have you got out here?
I've got a 9.
Mate, we're both a little short. You still think a 9-iron?
Yeah.
No doubt about you. That's beautiful. That's where you're aiming. It's coming in now. Still a little bit, you're aiming a little bit far out to the right.
To the right, yeah.
But that's something we'll pick up on the practice fairway.
Yep.
With our aiming. Now, Jake, here you are. You got about 25 yards, about 70 feet to the pin. 60 65, 70 feet.
Yeah, I've got a bit of obviously rough and undulating fringe to carry, so I've gone with a got a 52 degree out.
And you're going to carry it on the green about 2 or 3 yards?
Yeah, so sort of, I think it'll roll out about 1 to 1 really, so distance wise.
Yeah, basically, yeah, there's a spot there, you got a spot, haven't you?
I do.
Picked a spot, and it's definitely right to left, so you're a little bit right of the pin.
Okay, Jason, so you sort of ended up here just on the fringe, haven't you?
Yes, just off the edge. So.
Yep, got the putter out.
So pretty smooth there, not much grass,
yeah.
So it's pretty much like the green there, so
yep.
The old Texas wedge, and have a bit of a go that way. So we can get it nice and close and make the par. Shoulder, didn't it?
I gotta learn a bit from you there, buddy.
That's
right.
Long swing.
Really broke off there, didn't it?
Did what?
Okay, well, thanks, Jake. That little shot just skinny through the back of the green. So what's your plan of attack here?
So we've got a downhill slope here. So I just like there's a little ridge on the edge of the green now. So if I land the ball somewhere on there, it'll sort of funnel down.
Right. So this shot, make sure you got more weight on your left foot, so
yeah.
You're hitting it with a descending blow. Okay.
Yep.
And we'll watch it. You just listen for it to go in. Okay.
Sure.
What a nice
bad
shot.
Bad.
That's more like you, buddy. Excellent shot. Super.
Eliminate those bad ones, Pete, and you'll actually be a reasonable golfer.
Well, basically, I was very impressed with how you didn't overreact to that first chip shot you played.
Well, I think it's now just about reducing the amount of times that happens, because I do. That's my biggest issue right now, is I've got really inconsistent ball striking. Regardless of the shot I play. So I can now string together holes. So I birdied a nice par 4 yesterday. But yeah, and I'm playing a lot less of them, so.
Okay, so.
I'm happy with where I'm going.
Okay, so let's see what you're made of here, eh? Excellent putt. Good touch.
Boring in.
So there you go, eh? A bogey. Two bogeys. That's pretty good golf. Oh, very unlucky. It was a good strike. That hole was on a slight slope from your angle.
Yes.
Okay, Pete. Mm-hmm. So left it about 6 feet there?
Yeah, I left it a bit under the hole, and definitely it's going to come a little from left to right. Well, in the bottom. Okay, well, Jason, Scotty Ballack and the team here have been very, very busy on the course. You know, really, it's in great shape. And they've taken out a lot of the really, what do you call that, grass? Pandanus bushes?
Yeah, the bushes, yeah, the scrub. And
so
cleared it all out and made a lot more playable for the average golfer.
Yeah, so you know, it's still a great test of golf. You don't need all that stuff off to go and lose your ball. So course is in great shape, isn't it? Good condition.
It's fabulous, yeah, at the moment.
And we've got accommodation at the end of this hole. There's how many rooms are in next door?
There's about 120 rooms, I think.
So got accommodation right on the course.
Yep.
Playing on the peninsula, people can stay here, stay and play.
They can. Yeah.
Okay, so. How about we go, which one of those buildings are you going to hit?
I'm going to try and aim just at the one right behind the green there, and just try and hit it straight down the middle. We've got the wind following us, so we might get a bit of distance this time.
Okay, buddy. You did that, just that. What a shot. Straight at that building. Between the bunker and the right hand side, right in the middle.
It's the best one I've hit for a while.
Well, I know you've been training. You've been doing a lot of work in the pro shop and with the junior program, getting that underway here. That's been super.
Yes.
And of course, the beginner ladies, you've done really going well there, so that keeps you off the course, I know.
Shot there.
Right in the middle. I don't think I'll catch you, but I'm on the way. Jake's the guy that can hit it past both us here.
Yes.
But I think this time he's going to hit in the fairway.
That's right.
You're going to make sure the toe goes first, aren't you?
That's exactly right. Yeah.
Throw the toe, enjoy the hit. Sounded good. Okay.
The bunker.
Good contact though. Plenty of power.
So goslings.
Here is a swan and her goslings.
Yeah.
And we get a little closer, I think, before they'll chase us.
Yeah.
But the wildlife here is beautiful too. We got.
Yeah, look at her looking at us.
Hello there. Ah, beautiful. It's the springtime, down under.
Sure is.
So Jake, I noticed how you came in, you walked in from the entrance point to the bunker.
Yes.
You did the correct thing, good etiquette.
Yep.
Now you got you're a bit unlucky, you're behind the high bank here.
Yeah, I am, so I've not got a fantastic, I'm not going to, not a great footing, but you know, I'm 156 yards out, so I think I'll make the smart decision, just lay up.
Yeah. Take your medicine, get it out of the bunker. Yeah.
Next one on the green. There's plenty of ways to make a par. Well, you're out.
Shorter than I wanted, but...
Yeah, not it's out. So you, it's that's out. The first thing.
That's
okay.
Right.
I was playing with Bobby Clampett quite a few years back now, in a practice round for the Australian Open,
yep,
at Victoria Golf Club, and he told me about Ben Doyle, his coach, and the attitude that Ben instilled in Bobby then was, you know, you don't have, you know, there's a par's made by many different ways. Okay, so the idea now is for you to do the same thing, get the next shot, knock it up there close to the pin and hole the putt.
Exactly.
Plenty of ways to make a par. Jake, the ball's a little bit below your feet. The wind's coming a little bit from the left-hand side.
Yeah.
But I'd be aiming straight at the pin. What club have you got out from here?
So I've got a pitching wedge, actually.
Okay, so you're going to need a strong wedge. Okay. Bit of contact. Very good. See, that's where you're aiming. Beautiful contact. That's okay. I mean, I didn't go that far on my holidays. I couldn't hit a wedge that far.
Perfect. Yeah, just a little bit right. I could have been a little bit straighter, but that's okay. I'm a putt for the birdie.
That doesn't get out here a lot, that's pretty handy. But look, Jason, I know you've got to get back to the office.
Yes.
And just tell us a little bit about the junior golf program that we've got going here at Eagle Ridge, if you would.
Okay, so we've just started up term clinics this term, school term, fourth term of the year. They run every Tuesday at 4 o'clock. We're looking for kids between 5 and 12 years old, and older if they want to, but yeah, we're running them every Tuesday afternoon.
And beginner ladies, we've got beginner ladies, I know you're doing a good job.
Yeah, so we've got some beginner ladies clinics on Thursday afternoons, and they come every week and have an hour of learning all about the different things on the golf course.
So, great, yeah. And very friendly place. So
it is.
Thanks for coming out with us today.
No worries, mate.
And we'll catch up for some more holes next time.
Definitely, no
worries. Thank you.
Thanks, Jack.
Well, Jake, you were right. It came up a little bit shorter than I thought. I thought we'd have run out to the pin. But you got a, what, how long is it, 40 footer?
Yeah, it's probably about a 40 footer.
And it's uphill?
It is, yes.
And
it's kind of a hard one for me to read.
Well, okay, well, do you want me to give you a little bit of a tip on how to read this sort of putt?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so you're here, you know it's uphill.
Yeah.
But now, make a guess to which side is higher, left-hand side or right-hand side?
Well, just naturally I'm just going to... That's where it's deceiving. I'm going to say left hand side is higher.
Okay, well, walk on the right hand side and walk about halfway up.
Yep.
And about halfway up. Now, if you put your feet, now just walk out to the side a little bit. So you're out, so you got about.
Definitely, this side is definitely the long side.
Yep.
And we've got a little bit of a hump just here.
Okay. Well, that just walk out a little further away from the line. So you're too close to the line now. Just get out there and then just squat down there. You'll see. Get an appreciation of what the slope's now. It's definitely left to right, isn't it?
Yeah, not too much though, I don't think.
Okay, well, let's come back and see. Again, trial and error is going to teach us a lot, especially as, early days in golf.
Yeah.
But when you walk to the low side, it's much easier to make a positive assessment as whether it's left or right. So if you weren't 100% sure, if you walk to the other side, you'll really get a... Why don't you walk just for the moment? We're out here learning. So if you walk up there and you'll probably get a feel.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it does feel a lot higher.
Yeah. Your eyes can be deceiving, but once you walk there, you can feel the slope. kept your head down and you hit the ball, you made a good stroke.
Well, what I'm going to tell you, Jake, my ball's finished hole high.
Yeah.
Birdie putt. I've got about a 12 footer, maybe just a little bit more, but it's uphill and definitely it's right to left. I come up here and I look at the hole just to see if there's any grain, and I can see by looking at the hole this edge is sharper, so the grass is growing a little bit this way, so it will help make the ball roll right to left.
That grain of grass
did the job. You know, it's a nice putter, this one.
I tell you what, you can buy it.
Yeah, I tell you what though, it's the greens are good, and on top of that, when through having this bit of training, I've been working with the mind control, and I just feel so much more relaxed in putting. I'm not stressing, and I'm not so much into my technique. Just letting the feel, just I can see it. I have practiced the technique, but now I just let go of it out here. I'm just feeling the shot, and the belief system's in, and I feel like I can read greens well, and the results are happening.
It's a great birdie.
Thank you. Well, these are the good parts of practice. It's not a long putt. Beauty. Well done.